So we can trawl through the regulation and we can understand where and why the searches need to be done. But what about the databases? So this is what the regulation says. It says Medline or PubMed, they're the same thing. PubMed's free from the NLM. Medline is usually available through an aggregated provider such as Dialog or Ovid. So it says that Medline or PubMed can provide a good starting point for a search. However, with potentially incomplete coverage of European journals and research reduced search features, and PubMed certainly has reduced search features, if you use Medline through an aggregator, you get much more sophisticated search features that will enable you to do a far better search where the precision and the recall of the search are more finely balanced. So it says, it's saying essentially that just using Medline, you're not necessarily guaranteed a comprehensive search. So it goes on to say additional databases may be needed to ensure adequate coverage of devices and therapies in Europe to identify relevant clinical trials, publications of user experience. And they say that you may want to consider these additional journal databases such as Embase and Cochrane Central Trials Register. Now, an interesting thing about Cochrane is for certain countries, Cochrane is actually indexed in Medline. So you can actually do a Cochrane search in Medline. So Medline does cover the Cochrane database to a certain extent. There are some geographic restrictions on that, but it's always worth looking in Medline if you're using Medline and doing a search on Cochrane as the source to check and to see what is there. The regulations are very clear too on the requirements for the search. They say that you may need, or they recommend that you use the specialist to help, and that the search strategy has to be developed by iteration. So that's pretty obvious. You know, when you start a search strategy, you run a search strategy, you look at the results. Based on the results, you refine the strategy. If you're doing it on behalf of a client, then there's a to and fro with the client. You know, should you use thesaurus terms? Do you need to back up the thesaurus times by full text? And so on. And the thing to do, again, it sounds obvious, but when you get your results, if you find a paper that is absolutely spot on, then look at the title, the source, the keywords, the thesaurus terms of that paper, and make sure that you use that as a gold standard, and that the thesaurus terms and the search terms that enabled you to retrieve that key paper are strongly in your strategy. It's also very important for the regulations to demonstrate that you have created the search, the date on which you ran the research, the results, and any filters. So you need to document the search. And you need to have separate searches. So there should be a separate adverse event search, a separate clinical literature search, a separate current knowledge state-of-the-art search. So there will be a portfolio of searches to meet the various different criteria in the clinical evaluation reports. And also remember that this literature is going to be used downstream. So whether that's in some software product that you have, or whether it's going to a medical writer, it needs to be in a format that can be used for downstream. And so you need to be able to output your search in, for example, RIS, Word, Excel, or even XML. So also you need to be aware of what's going to happen with the literature once you've searched it, to make sure that you're not going to then create a bottleneck for whoever uses that literature to get it into a format that they can use easily and efficiently. So let's now look at the nitty-gritty and look at some search tips, and also look at some special indexing for making medical device searching easier. And I'm just going to take a couple of examples. So just an introduction to Dialog for those not familiar. So the Dialog platform is probably one of the most comprehensive sources of a wide range of databases. and it has a very wide range of databases relevant to medical device searching. Overall, Dialog has 140 different databases, and these range from engineering and biomaterials, which do has relevance for medical devices because they're often engineered products. They're often also combination products. So a drug evoluting stent, for example, is not only a medical device because of the mechanics, it actually contains a medicinal product, an active pharmaceutical ingredient. And Dialog has a very strong history in providing clients with the literature for adverse events of medicinal products. So we've been doing a lot of searching and research in this area. And I'll come on to some more detail of this, but this is just a general introduction where we did a search on the adverse effects of a medical device. And this is the range of databases that we found. So we really didn't quite know what to expect, but we found that and these results are deduplicated. So they are all unique items. So there's not any overlap. So 56% of the results came from Embase. Now, one of the reasons for that could be that Embase solely concerns itself with pharmaceuticals, and it's recently added some extra indexing for medical devices. And it's a very commercially orientated database. It also covers conference publications and conferences, actually, conferences. Whereas Medline, at only 17%, is essentially a public clinical database. It doesn't contain conference information, and it has excellent indexing, but it doesn't have any particularly specialist medical device terms. And we'll look at this in more detail. Health Research Full Text is a database that's unique to ProQuest and Dialog, and that actually has full text coverage from a whole range of health research. And nursing is important, and evidence-based medicine is very important for medical devices because you hear from the field a patient presented in a ward with X. So that's important. And then at 6% and at around 4%, you get two engineering databases, EI Compendex and Inspect are engineering databases. So again, this goes back to the fact that these devices have to be manufactured. They're using smart materials. Technology is advancing. Technology is being used to create these products. So you should not rule out searching in engineering databases. And then you have BIOSIS, and this is very important for preclinical work. So preclinical of any stage of any pharmaceutical product. And BIOSIS is very strong on this, and it also covers some patent information, plus it does cover conferences too. Current Contents is a great sort of source anyway, because it's multidisciplinary, and it looks at a wide range of scientific disciplines on a regular basis and gives you the current contents from key journals on the state of the art. Keeps you up to date on scientific practice. And then I mentioned nursing, and MCARE is a nursing database, and so a small amount of information from that. And then Northern Light Life Sciences is a conference abstracts database, and so that also had a little bit of relevant content. So just to say that the guidelines say don't just rely on Medline. They say you might want to also consider Embase and Cochrane. Cochrane's not available as a standalone database on Dialog, which is why it's not in this list. But Cochrane does appear in Medline, so you will be getting some Cochrane coverage.